Melanie Seacard here. Welcome to our cooking class. Welcome to my kitchen. And thank you for allowing me to share my passion of good food made real fast using clean ingredients. So before we get started, I would love to thank each and every one of you for watching. If you are catching this in a replay, hashtag replay. And what I will do today is I want to start us off by talking cocktails. So cocktails. It's beautiful outside. So I thought, what better way to come on, introduce some cocktails, and also make a dill pickle dip. So I'm going to show you guys exactly how easy it is to make, and we'll get started. Now, I do invite you in the next couple of days. You're going to see me in my kitchen. You're going to see me sharing recipes. Feel free to ask questions, comment. If you already own some Epicure products you want to share with each and every one of us, please feel free to do so. The more, the merrier, and the more innovation and inspiration we'll all get in the kitchen. So what you find here right now on my stovetop is Epicure's 8-cup multi-purpose pot, ergonomic handle, pour spout here on the top. It's actually a measuring cup on the inside in liters and in cups. And no more instant facelifts when we are straining our peas, our carrots, our pasta in the sink, because this bad boy has a lid with tempered glass that actually has strainers incorporated. So super easy, perfect for those that don't have the strength probably in their arm, or for children that are learning to cook, or for those campers that are going out camping, because it is a versatile pot. It also goes in the oven. It's a number one host choice. It's a number one seller. It was actually one of my first pots I purchased 15 years ago when I became a consultant, and I've never looked back. So what you'll find in my pot here is simple 2 cups of plain water. And what I'm going to show you is we're going to be creating right now a simple syrup using Epicure's Hibiscus Bliss herbal tea. Guys, if you guys are tired of having water and you just want to have something nice and refreshing that's healthy, you'll want to get one of the two of our herbal teas. They're only available during the summer months. So we've got the Hibiscus Bliss and the Blue Butterfly. So I'll often use it as an iced tea. So I'll just brew, you know, I'll use 2 to 3 of these tea bags to about 4 cups of water. I'll simmer it, stick it in the fridge. If you're like me, I'm not one that loves drinking something excessively sweet. So then I just use it as a nice tea. Though if you like sweet, then I encourage you to perhaps add 2 tablespoons here of Epicure's Summer Berry, or 1/4 cup of honey to have it a little sweeter for you. But today what we're gonna make is I'm actually going to make a simple syrup. Though I'm omitting, it's usually a cup, it's 1 part water, 1 cup sugar, though I am not doing that. I am doing two cups of water with 3/4 cup of organic sugar cane. So that's how I'm making my syrup. It's going to be as a lighter syrup. And what we're going to actually do is we're going to be adding, I'm going to be adding 3 tea bags here to the mixture. So I want mine a little stronger. The nice thing with creating your simple syrup is you can actually, once it's created, you can put it in a glass container and you store it in the fridge for approximately 6 months. Though if you wanted a little longer, you could add 1 ounce of vodka or gin to it and you can keep it and even store it on a shelf. You don't even need to actually put it away. So what we're doing, as you can see, we're getting that nice red color here happening. We want to let that seep and boil for about 10 minutes because we do want to create a syrup. So that's what I'm going to be doing right now. Though I have already prepared my absolute favorite, our Blue Butterfly. It's a simple syrup, the same way I'm preparing the hibiscus one. And what I'm going to do is I'm simply going to add 2 tablespoons here of my prepared simple syrup. Uh, And then what we're going to be adding is I'm going to be adding about an ounce of vodka. Now, I usually will use this just as a spritzer, so no alcohol, but I wanted to give you that option. So we're going to add about an ounce here of vodka, and we're simply going to add some Soda Stream water or Perrier, whatever you'd like to do, because I didn't realize a few years ago, but tonic water is very high in sugar. So I was kind of trying to avoid that. But as I said, I often will just take a tablespoon or two of this simple syrup to just some Perrier water or some Soda Stream with a hint of lemon. And I've got a nice refreshing drink on those really hot days. Though today I added the ounce of vodka. You could do gin. I usually do gin. I'm just out of gin. And look at the beautiful color that you're seeing seep through the glass here. Though we're, check the magic happen when I actually add a lemon. And that's the beauty of this tea. So I'm using Epicure's 2-in-1 Citrus Press. This is for your lemon. This is for your lime. Now it is made of steel. Logically, most people will put it in this way. If you do that, you'll probably give yourself an instant acid facelift, and you're not gonna like me. So you wanna make sure that you turn it upside down, palm facing down, and then just squeeze. It's perfect for fresh lemonade. It's just a simple, amazing tool to have in the kitchen. And the beauty of this, it's usually a number one over to our customers, a number one host pick. But it's actually that popular that it comes in Epicure's consultant starter kit. So if ever you're looking for a side gig, or you know, you're looking for something for added revenue, check out this next week, see what I do the next few days with me, and message me if you want some info. So check this out, guys. Everything is empty, no waste, and it actually holds up to the seeds. So that's for our drink, and you probably can see now we've got a nice pink formating on the drink. It's super tasty. It's really delightful. And we've got here again the hibiscus just kind of simmering here over. And it's going to give me again the simple syrup, which I store here in Epicure's Cruet. I find it's such a magic. It doesn't take space and it's perfect for those nights. Though I wanted to come on and hop on, and I will try to give you another different drink this week, because with the hibiscus you can use it for a sangria. So I often will make sangria with the hibiscus herbal tea, and I will rim the glass with our summer berry fruit dip. So simple and easy. I also have created lately that Starbucks kind of smoothie with that coconut milk. So that's something else that I do with the hibiscus. So it's a really a multi-usage for the teas. And that's what I love with Epicure. We're not just using a product to make one thing. I love to have a variety of things to do, because if it's coming in my kitchen, I don't want to just have one purpose. I want to be able to make a ton of different things with it. So as you can see, herbal tea turns into an alcoholic drink that can turn into a spritzer, that can turn into a sangria, and it can turn into a nice tea for you and your family and your kids. So as that is simmering, we're going to let that simmer a little longer. We're going to get working on a dill pickle dip. It's super yummy, it's super easy, and it's much healthier than what we buy in store-bought. So what you find here is the actual 4-cup prep bowl that Epicure owns, along with what I'm adding here is 3/4 cups here of plain Greek yogurt. As you can see right here, I just pulled out some plain Greek yogurt from my fridge, and we're going to be adding a tablespoon now of mayo. So super easy, just a tablespoon of that mayo. We're also now going to be adding to it, and I'm going to be chopping here, we're going to be adding 3 pickles here. So I'm just using dill pickle here. We're just going to slowly cut this up. You can put them as fine or as coarse as you like. I prefer to have chunks personally. I don't want them too fine. I want to actually be able to crunch in here to the dill pickle. So that's just by personal choice. So I'm actually going to put 3. If you want to add more, you certainly can. But super nice and light and refreshing, especially for those hot days. So we're just going to move this over here. And I'm going to just bring now my cutting board here to add my pickles to the bowl. So as you can see, super easy, nothing too hard to make. And we're going to add approximately a tablespoon of our lemon dilly dip. So one of our most versatile. So what I also tell customers is don't look that it says dips or vinaigrettes pasta sauces, because truthfully they're all mixes of spices blend together that you can really put in anything. I always say there's a rule of three for rice or pasta, for any type of protein, that it be animal protein or vegan protein, it works really well with black beans, with chickpeas, with chicken, beef, and any type of vegetable. So it really is just a mixture of spices. And we're going to add a tablespoon here into our dill pickle dip. So super easy. And yes, I am using our 4-in-1 spoon. So this is a tablespoon, a teaspoon here. We turn it around. This is a half of a teaspoon, and there's a little line here for the quarter. So if you need a quarter of a teaspoon, and if you're like me, I don't have excessive space in my kitchen. So everything's kind of have to be very compact and useful. So I like that it's got a multi-function for that. So we're going to just stir this up, and then we're going to add about 2 tablespoons of dill pickle juice, which I have in my prep bowl here. And we're just going to mix that up. Gosh, I wish you guys could smell through the camera here how good it smells. And we're going to add a tiny hint of sea salt, because that, with Epicure's product, for those that don't know, we are very sugar and sodium conscious. We are less than 5% of salt and sugar in all of our products. And many are actually lower than that in the sodium and sugar department. So if you are used to your store-bought, which many are, even though you say, Mel, I don't add usual salt in my stuff, there's already usually enough salt in the products we're buying, because that's one of the number one fillers that store companies do. We're at Epicure, we don't have the preservatives, the additives, the MSG. We're 100% gluten-free, we're 100% nut-free, we're at 90% vegan, and we're also 85% non-GMO. So it's really, really using clean ingredients. So I'm going to add a tiny bit of sea salt here to my dip. That's it, 4 little rounds. If you do own the grinders, do know I always say it's really, really intelligent. So if you own some of our jars and you have a coarser blend, for say, and you wanted to use it and coarse it down, and make it fine, our actual grinder heads fit on our jars. So on 95% of our jars, they simply don't fit on the dip jars. So you could certainly use your grinder heads on the jars. Now, and the nice thing with your grinder as well is that it is adjustable. So if you're going clockwise, you're going to a fine grind, counterclockwise, a coarser grind, and you use it like so. So I wanted kind of to show you that little trick and a little hack. So as you can see, my drink is ready. I've got my dill pickle dip ready that I can munch on with some fresh veggies, or that I can munch on with some crackers, and I can enjoy the beautiful weather. So I look forward to the week together. I look forward to the sharing ahead. Please share hashtag replay if you're catching the replay, and how you would use these syrups. Thanks so much for watching, and see you guys soon. Bye, everyone.